Hello everyone and welcome to another Neapolitan culture video in which today we will take a look and learn about Neapolitan art. We will learn about the best artists and art styles and see some of the most important art pieces that can be seen today. We will study Neapolitan art that includes paintings, sculptures, drawings and other works that all come from the Campania region of Italy. Also, we will see some of the best art museums and galleries that you must visit when coming to Campania if you are a big art lover. Art is important in life because it helps us emotionally, financially, psychologically, and even helps to shape individual and collective personality. So, why is Neapolitan art so cool and important? Well, let's find out. Naples has long been a centre of art and inspired by many artistic styles, such as medieval, baroque, and the Renaissance, amongst many others. A key factor in the development of the Neapolitan school of painting was Caravaggio's arrival in Naples in 1606. In the 18th century, Naples went for a period of neoclassicalism, following the discovery of the remarkably intact Roman ruins of Herculaneum and Pompeii. The Neapolitan Academy of Fine Arts, founded by Charles III of Bourbon in 1752 as the Real Accademia di Disegno, Royal Academy of Design, was the centre of the artistic school of Posillipo in the 19th century. Artists such as Giacomo di Chirico, Francesco Saviero Altamura and Gioacchino Toma worked in Naples during this period, and many of their works are now exhibited in the Academy's art collection. The modern Academy offers courses in painting, decorating, sculpture, design, restoration and urban planning. Naples is also the home of the artistic tradition of Capodimonte porcelain, which was porcelain produced in a factory in Palazzo di Capodimonte. It had a lustrous glaze and was usually pure white and contained a range of characters from the Commedia dell'arte. The factory though was later moved to Madrid, Spain, due to King Charles of Bourbon having Spanish descent. Many of the pieces are now on display in the Museum of Capodimonte. Several of Naples' mid-19th century porcelain factories still remain active today. The School of Posillipo is really important when talking about Neapolitan art. It was a loose group of landscape painters from the 18th century that were based on the waterfront of the neighbourhood of Posillipo in Napoli. It was not actually a school or an association, but more of a group of passionate painters that would paint landscapes together that were higher in demand than the everyday depictions of Catholic religious imagery. And these works were sold to Protestant buyers from Europe, who loved to buy their art during the Age of Enlightenment. The School of Resina was also a similar idea, in which the artists, namely painters, would gather at the seafront of Resina, now incorporated into towns of Herculaneum and Portici, just south of Naples. The group gathered around Giuseppe De Nitis, who after being expelled from the Naples Academy of Fine Arts, moved away from the city with the express hope of painting real life outdoors, instead of painting an indoor studio. Some of the notable painters from the schools include Giacinto Gigante, Federico Cortese, Domenico Morelli, Vincenzo Gemito, Antonio Mancini and Raffaello Pallicetti. One of the painters who inspired these schools directly was the great Italian painter Salvatore Rosa. Naples is embellished by a landscape without equal, but it is also a city full of museums, palaces and churches that guard works, paintings and statues of high artistic and historical value. So, let's take a look at some of the most important artworks in and around Naples that show the culture, art and charm of the history of the city and region. The Scourging of Christ. It is one of the most valuable paintings of the Capodimonte Museum. Created by Caravaggio between 1607 and 1608, and is one of the largest canvases of the last period of life of the painter, spent in Naples. It depicts Christ tied to a column, surrounded by three torturers, at the moment immediately preceding the scourging. The actions of the torturers are slow and precise, and all the figures are locked on the moment of maximum tension, on a dark background, typical of the Caravaggio style. It is precisely the mastery use of light to make the work a masterpiece, together with the naturalistic rendering and the sober colours. Ercole Farnese. The Ercole Farnese is one monumental marble sculpture from the Hellenistic period. Reproduction of a lost bronze sculpture is found in the National Archaeological Museum. It is part of the Farnese collection and was found in the baths of Caracalla in Rome in 1546, before arriving in Naples in 1787, thanks to Charles of Bourbon. The statue, in its grandeur, depicts the affirmation of man's courage on the jealousy of the gods, a value well represented by Hercules, son of Zeus, specifically the hero, tired after his legendary efforts, resting on a club. The martyrdom of Saint Orsola. Preserved in the Palazzo Zefalos, Stigliano, it is the last painting by Caravaggio, shortly before his death, that occurred in 1610. Moving away from the classic iconography of Saint Ursula, always depicted with the symbol of martyrdom and surrounded by virgins, Caravaggio immortalizes the saint at the moment in which he is pierced by the arrow of Attila, refused by her. Also in this canvas, there is a complex play of light and shadow, and Caravaggio represented himself in the face of a barbarian who rushes to help her, suffering as if he too had been pierced. An extreme and dramatic work with a high artistic value. Mithra and the Necklace of San Gennaro. The Gemmata Mithra of San Gennaro is the flagship jewel of the entire collection of the treasure kept in the museum, dedicated to the patron saint of Naples. It is a precious masterpiece made in 1713 by the goldsmith Matteo Treia of the Neapolitan school and is composed of about 3,700 rubies, emeralds and diamonds. Not of less value is the necklace of the saint, whose realization began in 1679 and which is composed of 13 solid gold links, with crosses stubbed with emeralds and sapphires. There are only a small part, even in the most irrelevant, of all the treasure that is considered the most precious in the world, even more than that of Queen Elizabeth of England. The Seven Works of Mercy. Painted between 1606 and 1607, it is located at the Piemonte della Misericordia and represents the seven works of corporal mercy. It is a very complex painting that brings together numerous characters and almost seems like it's set in an alley in Naples. In the upper part, there is the Madonna and Child, observing what takes place below, a scene in which the protagonists are divided into small groups, each of which represents one work of mercy. You can even see them high in voice details, like a drop of milk on a beard, and the shadow of the angels. Atlante Farnese. The Atlante Farnese is located in the Archaeological Museum, in the beautiful Salone della Meridiana, which is one of the Hellenistic Age, but also certainly a copy of the lost original. It is a very impressive sculpture that depicts Atlas's intent on holding the Earth globe on his shoulders. The map is reproduced on his globe, the most ancient and complete representation of the celestial sphere, with the constellations represented as they would be observed in 1209 BC and catalogued in a volume by Hipparchus of Nicaea, which inspired the author of the statue. The fatigued expression of Atlas and the musculature in evidence make the work very significant. Vesuvius. Preserved in the contemporary art section of the Museo di Capodimonte, the canvas is a tribute to the American pop artist Andy Warhol, who wanted to dedicate one of the most represented symbols of the city to the people. The work, in fact, depicts the Vesuvius in eruption and was realized in 1985 on the occasion of the exhibition Vesuvius by Warhol, thanks to the collaboration with the Neapolitan gallery owner Lucio Amelio, who is credited with having brought the American artist to the city. In perfect pop style, the image of the volcano is reproduced with bright colors and not very realistic. This is one of the many works that inspired Warhol. Veiled Christ. The Veiled Christ is a marble statue located in the San Severo Chapel and realized by Giuseppe San Martino in 1753. It's considered among the most important marble sculptures in history, particularly the veil covering the face of Christ, realized by the same block of the statue and perfectly adherent to the face. San Martino was thus able to transmit the suffering of Jesus before the crucifixion. According to a legend, the client and alchemist Raimondo di Sangro taught the sculpture how to calcify a tissue, and for centuries it was believed it was the magic of marbling. Strozzi Table. It is a painting from 1472 by an unknown artist located in the Museo della Certosa di San Martino. It represented one view of Naples during the Aragonese period, one of the oldest images of the city. The work depicts the return of the Aragonese fleet after the victory of Ischia against Giovanni d'Angio, pretender to the throne. The view of Naples is from the sea with the pier in the background, And you can see the Maschio and Gioino, the Castel Carmine, some churches and buildings. It has an incalculable historical value and is the most beautiful urban representation of the 15th century, with the city surrounded by walls and all developed to the east. Baptistry of the Duomo. The Baptistry of San Giovanni Infante in the cathedral is of the early Christian era, probably of the 4th century, and is the oldest in the West. It is located in the old cathedral, in the Basilica of the Santa Restituta, today connected to the current chapel. It consists of the baptismal hall and a rectangular portico with four columns covered by a low vault. This one was covered by beautiful mosaics, of which today you can admire a good portion, in blue and turquoise. They represent a sky with stars golden, white and blue, with a monogram of Christ, and there are decorations with branches, birds and a precious blue cloth. Madonna with Child and Two Angels. The Madonna with the Child and Two Angels is an important painting by Sandro Botticelli in the Capodimonte Museum, dated 1468 to 1469. It depicts the classic image of Mary with the child Jesus with the background of a rocky landscape. The characters have a serious and thoughtful tone, above all the two little angels, and the depth of their moods is accentuated by the landscape itself, which here has no longer only a decorative function. This work contains many elements typical of Botticelli's art, both in the perspective composition and in the use of chiaroscuro. Now that we have seen some of the most important Neapolitan artworks, let's take a look at the art galleries and art museums in the Campania region.
Museums in Campania: Vasovia Contemporary Art Museum, Diocesan Museum of Amalfi, Museo d'Arte in Avellino, Museo Liverino, National Archaeological Museums in Naples, Royal Palace of Caserta, Palazzo delle Arti di Napoli, Secret Museum in Naples, Museo di Capodimonte, Cappella San Severo, Piemonte della Misericordia, Palazzo Zevallo Sostigliano, Certosa di San Martino, Museo Civico Filangieri, Girolamini in Naples, National Museum of Ceramics in Naples, and Villa Pignatelli in Naples.
And that's it. There is so much more to cover that we will cover in detail in future videos. But for now, that is the basics. If you made it this far, then congratulations, you are now more wiser with Neapolitan art. Thanks for watching our video. If you enjoyed it, please leave us a like and comment with your thoughts, opinions and questions. And if you haven't done so already, subscribe to our channel for future videos. Also, clicking on the notification bell will allow you to be notified first when a brand new video has just been uploaded. See you all in the next video.